having people come together that are, many of them, on the receiving end of a system that throws people out, that doesn't take care of people, that puts money into military instead of into housing for homeless people or healthcare. So it brings together a lot of different issues with people from faith-based community, people from different movements, poor people themselves, and I think it's a great coming together. Now, the most important thing is really what happens in the states, because I've been traveling around the country and I see in some of the states a lot of really great coalition building that will have much more of a life after this. It really fits so much into our whole mission of taking money out of the bloated Pentagon budget and putting into people's needs, the environment, making the world a better place to live in. So we're really excited about all the alliances that we've made during the course of this Poor People's Campaign, how much people get the military part of things, because a lot of times in these coming together of different organizations, it's around domestic issues, which are all really critical, but they forget to look at what is the militarism part of it that's sucking away so much of our funding. So we have a campaign that's to divest from the war machine, and we're going around to cities and pension funds and individuals and universities and members of Congress to say there's a way we can separate ourselves from that war economy by making sure that we're not invested in it. And that's what we're going to keep doing as part of our piece of the pie for the Poor People's Campaign.
Everybody's got a right to live, and before this campaign fails, we'll all go down to jail.